Tonight's topic is transportation. I had to bring something just in case my assistants didn't help me out, but my assistants came through. So what I did is I brought this, and I brought some places where I've got my plans, but we'll talk about this later. What I want now is my assistants to do this, to come up. I want them to come over here, and you're going to stand over here and make sure you place your object on this table, i.e. if this is your object, you place it on the table, and if you want to turn it, you do this. Don't do this and this, okay? Just turn it like that. Otherwise, you will be running the camera. And explain, what I'd like you to do, explain what it's made from, maybe where the pattern came from, maybe approximately how long it took to make. If you've got parts from someplace, wheels or something, explain that. But just kind of explain to them so people might think about making it. Then, i.e., after this is over, if you need more information, you could go see that person and make, because a lot of this stuff, to be honest with you, I'm not being belittling anything, a lot of it doesn't take that much time or materials. You probably got the materials in your shop already for some of them. Okay, and let's start.
Okay, this is a Steve Good pattern. I realized after I finished, there's one thing I would do different the next time. I would make the base a little longer. Since it already has a clock, I'd make a little pen stand with a pen. But that's it.
What about wood?
I don't know what's that cool.
Now, Alan said you wanted to have people do some things for the transportation, and my wife is an antique dealer, so she's constantly bringing me old books on how to make toys or how to make woodworking projects. But she gets to the antique ones. This was the book I came from. It's probably, 50, 60 years old. It's from the father of her business partner. He made a lot of these things. So these are just afternoon projects, as they call them, for in that thing, simple things. This is made out of cypress. It's a simple old car, most of it's 3/4 inch. Glued up a block for that. I obviously did not do the wheels. I bought those from Hobby Lobby, and they use the peg type axles. They go in so that they'll turn. This is what they call a furniture button. I didn't glue it in. And that's just, something that goes in the same kind of way. Actually, that's another one of those axles. I just put the axle, that's just the hub. I just cut it shorter. The lights, the balls cut in half. They were pre-drilled with a hole, and an 1/8 inch hole, so they're glued on 1/8 inch dowels to go into the body of the thing. Okay, I need to turn them up. Okay, sorry.
Camera wasn't hitting.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Turn 180 if you need something back.
Yeah, that's basically all that is. It's just scrap cypress. A friend of mine is building a huge cypress outdoor cabinets, set of cabinets. So he gave me a lot of the scraps. And again, this is another scrap pieces, oak. I believe these decks are cherry. It's just the dowels. And it's got the hot rubber bands.
It will float.
The original plan called for to put it on wheels, but it used wooden spools, which are almost impossible to get anymore. So I just said, although it was at Hobby Lobby today, and I noticed they had wooden spools there. So I may put it on wheels. I'm not sure if I'll do that yet or not. But that's and it had a if it, in that case it had a little poster that you'd have a drawstring so the kids could pull it. So I may put that in, I may not. I kind of like the idea of it just being maybe kind of a bathtub type toy.
Okay, anything else over there? Oh, yep.
One more.
Yep. This is now, remember I said, we went three-dimensional, we went moving, we went toys, we went clocks. Now we've got fretwork.
This is fretwork. This is actually out of a quarter inch, which I normally use eighth inch, but this is a quarter inch, so I only could only stack up three of these, and I made the frames for them. I think this is a pattern. I'm not sure if I got this out of the scroll saw magazine or if I got this from Wooden Teddy Bears. One of the two.
I almost want to say scroll saw magazine, I think.
I think it was in scroll saw magazine.
Is that oak?
It's...
Oak ply, maybe.
It's a plywood, and I'm not sure if it's oak or cherry. It might be a cherry ply. I think it's a cherry ply.
But remember, you want to cut those in his, because he uses quarter inch or eighth inch or whatever.
That was from the call.
You want to stack cut them because you need resistance. It's easier to cut three than it is to cut one for those that haven't done that. It's much easier. Even though you may screw up three, it's easier to cut three. You will screw up less by cutting three than trying to cut one because of the resistance.
You sneeze, if you only have one, you sneeze, you're halfway across the board. And that's
any questions? Question?
After you.
Plywood?
Yes.
That's some of your real small spots that you had.
And add strength, because you're going in all sorts of directions. You have some pretty thin pieces. That allows you to get that strength no matter which direction the thin piece happens to be.
And in some cases, if you do have that thin piece, and sometimes this is the way I do it, is when I'm doing it, I may leave the piece in there and take a piece of packing tape and leave it in there. So that way, even though it's detached because I've cut all the way around it, it still strengthens that piece when I'm trying to cut against that other side. So I may leave some of those pieces in there. Now, if you leave too many, and you take them out when you're done. But if you put too many in there, what happens is, especially if you're doing a little piece like this or whatever, and you don't get the tape on it, it'll invariably go down just enough so it falls in the slot on your saw and you can't move.
Absolutely. Which is why I take them.
Okay, remember, your blade goes through the hole. Okay, if you're cutting, you've cut this, now I'm cutting here. If this piece, I had cut it, and I didn't get it totally in there, it will fall down and get in that hole, and now I can't, why won't my blade go? Because the waste piece is stuck on the edge of that hole.
Which is the reason, the way I approach it, it's a little different, is that I always take those pieces out here, because that just, has too much, it happens every time without fail.
Yeah.
Even if you're on the same piece you're cutting. So what I do is I always start in the center, and my cuts that I make are always, if I've cut out this piece and I'm starting to cut this thread in here, I'll always cut the side closest to what I've already cut first. And that way I cut it away from the weak piece while still attached to the strong piece. And in that case, as long as I do that, I have never blown out a piece. The one time I forgot it and did it, I blew it out and ruined six blanks.
And the other thing when you're doing fretwork, and a lot of times you forget, even when I'm doing 3/4 inch over there, okay, I'm cutting this piece right here, and I started down here and I went all the way around and I'm coming back over here. Before I get over here, when I get about right here, my finger should be right here on top of that piece. Because when I get here and I don't have my finger on that piece, it doesn't flap. It goes boom and takes out everything else I have. That angle will wedge and it will tear your stuff out even on a 3/4 inch thick piece.
Yeah, and that's
it'll pop and it'll just break everything out. See, before, even if it's a small, tiny piece, put your finger on it so it stays in place. I'm just, that's, That's just my personal.
The other thing that I do, that I had a voice, the biggest blade I'll use is a number three.
Yeah.
Because the finer the blade, the less you have that problem.
We got 8.3, right?
And the tighter turns you can make without having to do a lot of work like what Tom's explaining earlier. You can make the tight turns easier with the smaller blade. So I use either a number one or number three blade on pretty much everything I do. They wear out fast, but it makes it easier.
Okay.
Blades are cheap.
So we covered a little bit of that. Okay, now we'll come up here. Just in case my assistants didn't, you know, I asked them to do it, and they did a phenomenal job. You know, there's a lot of stuff there. Is there anything possibly that somebody might maybe make for a Christmas gift? Okay. Now, I brought some interesting stuff, and I'm going to say, except for this train, everything was made from my scrap pile. Okay? And all these cars are different in a way. But you got to think about it this way. If I'm doing a car, okay, how many people have taken a pine knot and thrown it in the trash? Because it's a knot. Well, I don't want to cut a knot. If it breaks, I'd be a big problem. Okay, my case, I cut it, put my pattern on it. If it works, fine. If it doesn't, then I can burn it, okay? But here, that's a solid oak, okay? This one, and a bunch of them were in Scroll Saw Magazine. You know, that limousine sells like every kid wants a limousine, okay? Okay, these here are here. Okay, and we'll talk about the boots in a second here, but that's where they're made. And I don't know what it is. It's a car, I'm sorry. Cameraman, it's a car. Plus, yeah, I know. I can't do a lot. It's about everything I'd have to do. But they like the idea that the stuff can go in it. You know what I'm saying? They like the idea something can go in it. You gonna have me put it over there, or we're gonna put it right here? Okay. And then you got these here, here. Come on, get the table up there. I mean, these are four. I think there's like 10 patterns of these. Kids love them. Sharp vehicle. Okay, now, before I do these, before I sell them, okay, even if I have them in my booth, when the child gets it, even if my wife is there, he says, oh, son, you need to give it to the person over there so it can go through the auto shop to check. So what happens is, when this sets up, sometimes, even though, well, you do, the glue sets in there, so I make sure all the wheels work when they do. Because sometimes, little piece of glue in there, and they set up, they're fine when they left the shop, but they set up. So you have to go to the mechanic, he has to check road test your car out before it goes. But I'm saying, those always work well. But see, little pieces of scrap that you would normally throw away, okay? And like I said before, and I didn't have it up here, this one, this one. This one, this one, this one, this one, that one, that one, and that one, and this one, and that one are all in the Scroll Saw Magazine. All in the Scroll Saw Magazine, and they're all the kids. Oh, that's Mom's car. This is a limo. You know, they recognize the different cars, you know. And, you know, solid blocks or whatever you do. Okay. Okay, now, the ones that are fun to do. Here's a Volkswagen Rabbit. Okay. Here's where I got to take it through the thing. Here's the pig. You know, here's just a, you know, what's funny, this is one of my better selling cars. Kids don't have things like that anymore. Everything is so commercialized and painted and whatever it is, they can't have imagination. So these are just rough. Okay, the other thing is, all of my things, now these, just the wood happened to have finish on, the wood happened to have finish on these. But basically, I either use mineral oil and beeswax to finish mine, or I don't put anything on. Because then what I do, number one, it's one less step I have to do. I can say it's raw wood, and the kids can paint them or color them however they want. Okay? That way they've taken care of and I haven't taken care of. Okay? Here's a duck. Here's a pickup truck. Okay? Here's a Ford Mustang. You know, here's an elephant. You know, everybody has to have one of these. Squirrel car. Gotta have a squirrel car, you know, screeches to a halt. Here's another one that goes over here. But, you know, there's a lot of other ones up here, but I'm just saying, it's basically, it doesn't take a whole lot of wood and just different shapes. Am I getting close? Different shapes. What I'm saying, you just make them, and you make them out of that piece of scrap you have. And if you have some, you make three or four of them, and then all my wheels are drilled straight through, and mine have a wheel and an axle. I mean, a wheel and a pin. I buy them in packs of thousands. You say, well, that's not much, but 1,000 times 1,000 divided by four on a vehicle, you know, they don't make a whole lot. Now, along that same line, I was messing around, and I made this. I was just playing around. I saw a pattern, and I was playing around. It's a, you know, and this comes off, and it goes down. Similar to those big ones, those guys up there, but my scrap pile doesn't have big stuff in it, okay? I mean, it's got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 wheels on it, okay? It's not an 18-wheeler, good thing. But, surprisingly enough, I took him to a show and said, okay, yeah, okay. I can't keep them in stock because of this factor. The kids come up and say, Dad, I've got to have this. It's a matchbox hauler. It's not as big like that, but the kids love it because, you know, they can haul their matchbox on it. So anyway, so that's just an idea that I had and came up like that, and that's where it came. Okay, now. That gets rid of these, okay? Then you can do puzzles. You know? There's the front end of a Volkswagen. And there's a lot of, you know, it wasn't a truck though, was it? It was probably a van, wasn't it? Whatever. But I'm just saying. What I'm saying, that's another one you can do like that, okay? And they're good. Okay? Along that same line, there's an ambulance. Am I in the right spot? Buzz, I can't see. Oh, there I am. Okay, I can see it. I'm looking there now. Okay, now, I'm going to take these two. Not simple, not thing. Okay, now, this is a place where I'm going to talk about it. Okay, you notice on this one right here, there are 1, 2, 3, only 4, 5 pieces in there, okay? The rule of thumb that I use on most of my stuff, and sometimes you can't get around it, a toilet paper tube that you use, okay? If the piece will not go through that toilet paper tube, then it's okay for very, very, very small kids. And I have... The wheels, I explain to them and tell them that, whatever, but I'm just saying, yes, these are small. Wheels can break off anything. Even though you got a big piece, if they drop it on the floor, it can become a small piece. So, you know, I just have to tell them. These, I've taken these and taken them to daycares and other places and let them throw them around and whatever. Those wheels are glued on really, really tight. And the wheels themselves are going to break. And you run into that on anything. I mean, you got to use a little bit. There's been some Facebook stuff on whatever it is. Parents don't do what we, when we grew up like we do now, and they don't watch them as close as they do. But I'm careful when I do it. I just have to. But that's just the general rule of the thing. If I'm making a section that I've got, and somebody says I got a small child, I have a shelf that's strictly those type items that I do, okay? Like pieces like this, it's only 3 pieces or whatever. Okay. Now, these two... Plus another one, we're just in the last scroll saw magazine. You guys remember those?
They were in the last Girl Scout magazine, fold-out. And they're different models. I can't, one's a Volkswagen Bug. I can't tell you what, I'm not a car person, so. Okay. Now, cameraman, you're going to move because I'm going to do something right here for right now. Here, 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 and here. Okay, now, okay, we got a tractor. We got a helicopter. We got a helicopter, a car, a train, and we said transportation, right? A rocking horse? That's close, isn't it? But anyway, these five, okay? 15 minutes. Okay? I made them in 15 minutes.
All five?
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, think about it. There's not any cut. There's hardly any cuts. And when I cut fairly fast. No, what I'm just saying. So I'm, you know, they don't take all day to cut. If you needed something to take, if you had a Saturday in the workshop, anybody could get these done very easily. They're not that difficult. And see, like this one, if you look at it, it's 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. Okay. One. This one doesn't have one. This has one. This has one. That has one. This has one. Okay, now this one I modified a little bit. You can see how I modified this one? The tail was supposed to be a separate piece, but to me it was too small. So that's why I made it with that piece attached. The tail was supposed to be a single piece. But anyway, the rocking chair, the helicopters sell well, but they're simplistic puzzles, small puzzles for kids. Okay? And those were either a Steve Good or whatever, it was a free pattern somewhere, okay? Here's another one that was in that thing I think we had over there, okay? This one you all have seen before. I made two of these from one 2x4. This was my thing from the 2x4 contest. And it's seven vehicles. The wheels and the pegs are purchased, and if you look, cameraman, can you see? It makes it relatively simple. These parts are all the same too. If you look right here, I just made a bunch of those, which are the, not really the axle, it's basically a hitching thing. And I just made a bunch of those, and they just went on each one. You notice they're the same on each one. And then what I did is I took one of the wheel pegs and used it as my axle piece and made sure I had plenty of, so they can put them in any order they can. Even this one, I added one to it. So if they wanted to put a car, put the caboose in the middle of the train, they could put the caboose in the middle of the train if that's what they wanted to do. But, you know, kids always like trains. And like this case, I left it natural so the kids could paint it whatever they wanted to paint it. And it becomes their own. And in my case, this was the excess for my 2x4, and this was the excess for my 2x4. But anyway, so that's one thing to do. And surprisingly enough, it does, I mean, usually a train doesn't have that big a, usually doesn't jackknife, but it will, you know, it rolls pretty, you know, rolls pretty good for a wood type train. Okay, now, we've seen a lot of patterns. We've seen a lot of things. The other thing you can do on these is round balls or square balls on pegs. You remember, may have been after we grew up when our kids, when our young, some of our young kids, remember they had the ones that were, all the people were dowels and they fit in? You could do that so they could move it from, you know, they could put a dowel in a truck or whatever. That's just something to do. These just happen to go, come, you know, they go in here and they can go in any car or whatever. But most of this stuff is just made out of scraps that are sitting around. In this case, these are just three pieces of wood. And you cut a bunch of them and you just put them together. Okay? I didn't bring it. Should have. I didn't find it. But remember this one?
I mean, there's, that's transportation, right? Doesn't Santa get around in the sleigh? So, I mean, that's one thing to do. These, a bunch of these patterns here are from a site. It's, they've changed their name. Help me out, guys, somebody. They used to be Toymaker Press, then somebody stole their website, and now they're called...
Toymaker Plans.
Anyway, if you sign up with them, they will send you emails about their newest plan that they have or whatever, and give you deals to buy them. And sometimes they'll do and say, for instance, this one. This was a free weekender plan. Now, these are all PDFs. And I have just downloaded them, and I made them into books for myself. I still have the PDFs on my computer for printout, but this just gives me something to, you know. And the nice part about their plans, in a lot of cases, they will show their plans in natural. Don't forsake me this time. And then they show them, well, this one's going to mess me up. Maybe it's this one. But I'm saying, see, this is painted, but then they also give them to me. There's painted, and then there's non-painted. But they'll do a lot of their toys in that. And this is where I got the mineral oil and beeswax, equal amounts. You take mineral oil, put it in a saucepan, then you take beeswax, taking a carrot grater, and just get the mineral oil heated up, and then just grade the beeswax in there. And then when it looks like a pretty good mechanism, just take it off the side and let it set. If you want to hurry it up, you can put it in the refrigerator. But what it does, it becomes like a paste wax. And then what you do is just wiping on the stuff. Mineral oil is used as, you know, people partake of it to help them out doing certain things. And then, and then beeswax is beeswax, so it's edible. So that the two edible things go together.
That is flammable.
It is flammable, but what I'm just saying, you just got to be careful. Okay, now, I'm glad he brought it, but here's one. This is Skull Woodworking. I didn't make one. I didn't bring one tonight, but here's a rubber band boat. I mean, it's a little bit different than that one. He's got the fancy one where they gamble on. This is your everyday runabout, okay? This is for the small bathtub. This is for a luxurious bathtub. Then you've got this one. Here's easy, quick toy patterns, and you know there's your piece list. You know, I'm just paging through this to give you an idea. You know, and they're basically, a lot of them are similar to what you saw over there. Some of them are, this one's, I'm going to say, a lot of them are more, you got more detail. Some of them not as much detail, but I'm saying. So there's a bill. Here's another one. This is airplanes. Okay, this one is just, I want to say, is this where that came out of? I'm not sure where that one came out. Okay, here's another one that's just on, this is boats. Okay, here's one on cars and trucks. Probably similar to what we had over there. These guys, my assistants really came through for me. See, there's a fire truck. But see, here's, I got to get more angle, I'm sorry. Okay. There it is colored. There it is, just raw wood. What I'm saying, they make good patterns. I've made some suggestions over the time that I bought these things from them that, you know, they would take their patterns and they would have their page here, and if they had a pattern here, they would have a tendency to put another pattern on top of it. If there was a blank space, they'd have two patterns, and I said, that's a no-no. That don't work for me, because now I got to make two copies of that, and I never make two copies, I make one copy, and then I don't have the two pieces because I don't want to have this one, you know what I'm saying? So now they keep them all together, and what they've done, if you've ordered these plans in the front, let me see an example if I've got one. Quickly, maybe this one was what they'll do in the front is if you come down here real quickly, it'll say this one's table cut, but a lot of times they'll say pages 9 through 17 are the pattern pages. You know, everything else is in there, but if you print page 9 to 17, you'll have all the patterns. And they don't do a big pattern inside. They don't do little patterns on top of a big pattern inside because they were trying to save space. I said, that's great for saving space, but it's a pain for us as a maker because now we make one thing, we get all ready to do it, and now we don't have all the patterns we need because we got three pieces on top of this pattern, and we either have to cut out and make a wholly big piece, you know, which drives you nuts sometimes. That's just me personally, but anyway. So this was weekend patterns. Sometimes you can take your cars and stuff and do stuff like this. You know, if you want to make, we did it in another thing called play sets. You know, here's one where you got all kinds of different little cars, and they can be painted or they can be raw. And then you make a gas station or a drive-in or whatever. This, in case, was a diner, okay? So the kids can play. They can imagine, not like a lot of these electronic toys they have now. You know, they can play and they can make it whatever they want it to be. Here's one on just doing train sets. I mean, there's numerous different styles of train sets in this one. And their patterns are fairly good. This one is an animal train, circus train. Here's another one that's, you know, passenger car train. Here's one that gives you the stuff to go on the outside, you know, the scenery and stuff. Here's another one that's turtles and animals and circus performers and stuff, okay? Here's another one that's rabbits or donkeys, I can't see from this side. Here's elephants. So you can make an elephant train. So there's a lot of different ones. Here's another one on, you know, we talked about boats. Here's Noah's Ark. That's transportation, right? Trying to fit it in, guys. I mean, I'm sorry. Okay, and here's something. If you get it, they send you the newsletter, and you say, okay, I'm not going to buy any plans from them, but they'll give you plans, and they have specials on them, and there's whatever. And a lot of their plans are sold at other stores, but if you buy them directly from them, they're a lot cheaper. And they do have some books, but most of their plans are PDF. So, oh man, I forgot. There's a birthday coming up on Saturday, and it's Thursday. I need to make some cards for my nephew or whatever for that birthday. I don't have any plans. Well, you could go out there and let's say I'm going to make this. If you wanted this, you can go out there, give me your credit card, and within 2 minutes, you've got all the plans because you can download them. They're PDFs, and you can download them. And to me, I like the hard copies, but once they're on the computer, you don't have to go to a copy store. You don't have to go someplace else. You can print out what you need and whatever you have it. You can catalog them, which I don't do as good a job as I should, but what I'm just saying, these are things. Then there's some books, hardbacks. Here's one on natural wooden toys. It's got a lot of, I'm going to call simplistic toys, but yet, you know, here's taking like almost what's on that table up there, and you make a helicopter-like shape, okay? Get in closer if you can, sir, on that. Forget about me. But what I'm saying, all they did is put a propeller on the top. And you can make them natural or you can make them like that. The other thing is, here's where they're, in their case, what they're using is vegetable dye. They're using dyes that we use for vegetables that they use for making, if they want it red or blue or green or whatever, they just use vegetable dyes to get around the thing. Yes, sir?
Yeah, the other thing is that people do is use food color.
Well, food dye and vegetable dye.
Can you use fabric dyes too?
Fabric dyes sometimes no, because they have, they may have some chemicals in them that
has to be food safe.
Fabric dyes do?
Yeah.
Okay.
Put it in your mouth. Chew on your shirt.
Yeah, wouldn't have thought about that, but okay. But anyway, so that's what they use a lot of times. I mean, we think that's simplistic, but that right there from an educational toy, I mean, yeah, it's a block of wood, which we did, and basically cut it three times to give it those shapes. But when it's out, it's a puzzle. They got to put it back together. They can you know, use it as three separate pieces, or they can use it as one piece together. You know, here's simple patterns of trees and animals and whatever. But, you know, there's all kinds of books and stuff out there. There's all kinds of stuff. I probably have more than I probably should have, but that. And then if you go to this, then along the way, they come out with things like this every once in a while. These are like their 100 toy makers. And they get together, and the toy maker will send in their plan for whatever they wanted, or send in, they may not send in their plan, but they may send in what they make. So what it does, it gives you the ability to, like, here's teething toys. You know, if you had a little baby and you needed a teething toy, you can make a teething toy. If nothing else, here's remember this one? We did this one, I think. Remember, George, we made the teetery-tot deal we were trying to go across? I mean, you know, this one's just got, I mean, every page is a different one. There's 100. And sometimes I look at, oh, look at there. I think we've seen some of that today, haven't we? Close to that or similar to that. But I'm just saying, you know, they go bigger stuff and whatever, but I'm just saying, it's things we don't think about. These are toys that go above the crib. You know, it's different types of things. I know we're transportation, but, you know, I'm just saying toys. Here's tops, spinners, that type of stuff. Anything else we need to talk about? Did we cover? Huh?
We need to go.
Okay, we will. Did we cover everything we needed? Hopefully tonight was helpful. How many people might make something that we saw tonight? Yeah, got 50% anyway. But anyway, I thank you. Sorry I didn't saw tonight. I know you're probably glad about that, but I appreciate it, and I will try to get us better programs in 2017.
Good job.